What will the cities of the future look like? Flying vehicles, mega bridges, underground spaces and high-tech street experiences are the first ideas that come to mind. But for billionaire Marc Lore, the answer is eco-friendly skyscrapers on 150,000 acres of desert land. Marc Lore, a former Walmart e-commerce executive and co-founder of Jet.com, is aiming to lay the conceptual and financial groundwork for Telosa, a utopian city in the middle of the desert. Telosa intends to usher in a reformed brand of capitalism that prioritizes societal participation over the current divide. Lore envisions Telosa having equitable access to healthcare, great education, and safe settings for families of all income levels. He also wants Telosa to be a varied community with people of many ethnicities, genders, sexual orientations, faiths, and political affiliations. However, constructing a future city is both risky and complicated. Experts and researchers have long argued that too many financial obstacles can stymie eco-cities' ability to achieve their utopian ambitions, with one study arguing that the ability of eco-cities to achieve their utopian ambitions may be limited by the realities of operating within a profit-driven, entrepreneurial planning environment. However, Lore believes Telosa can be different in this regard, and comprehending the massive how of the project means understanding the why for Lore. Telosa gets its name from the ancient Greek word telos, which means higher aim. And if you look at Telosa's conceptual art, it appears to be lifted straight from a science fiction film. Solar energy appears to power nearly everything, including self-driving electric cars and high-speed public transportation. Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell if you would like to be the first to learn more about incredible billion-dollar megaprojects from around the world. Telosa zeroed in on the $400 billion target, which will require huge buy-in from major investors just to get the project off the ground. With Lore's high aspirations, beginning with the first phase of 50,000 live citizens to be welcomed into the city by 2030, public skepticism is very clear. I'm not doing this for the money. I'm doing it because of the implications for the future. If this entire initiative fails, hopefully, there are lessons to be learned and it will inspire others to give it a chance, said Lore. Lore is aware of the challenges that can result from affixing his name and value system to a city from the ground up. However, the entrepreneur stated that his function is primarily to serve as a placeholder for the people to establish the city's culture on their own. Telos's official website encourages future residents to stay connected to their community and nature while setting a global standard for life with the purpose of increasing human potential. The Lone Star State is one of several locations in the United States being considered for the site of Telosa. Telosa supporters predict that the built-from-scratch city will cost more than $400 billion to complete over a 40-year period. They expect the first phase, which would cost more than $25 billion and cover 1,500 acres, to be completed in 2030. According to Bloomberg Businessweek, each 1,500-acre neighborhood would be surrounded by future tiers of 1,500-acre neighborhoods. If Texas added a city with a population of 5 million people, it would become the state's largest city. In today's figures, the population would outnumber the combined populations of Austin and San Antonio. In comparison, both the Dallas-Fort Worth and Houston metro regions have populations that exceed 7 million people. The city's transportation will be a major feature of Telosa, with Telosa's streets preferring bikes and pedestrians. According to Telosa's official website, climate change will affect 1 billion people by 2050. This figure is consistent with a United Nations climate change assessment issued in August, termed a Code Red for Humanity, which stated that the Earth might hit 1.5 degrees Celsius by 2040. It is unknown which American desert will be used for the project. According to the city's official website, Nevada, Utah, Idaho, Arizona, Texas, and the Appalachian area are also all viable alternatives. Lore has handpicked world-famous architects Bjarke Ingels Group to lead the structural design. A massive tower known as the Equitism Tower is planned to be a beacon for the city with its Eiffel Tower-like aura in one of the mock pictures of Telosa. The initial phase of development would contain 50,000 inhabitants spread across 1,500 acres. It is predicted that it would cost $25 billion to build. The ambitious target is to have residents by 2030. Lore went on to say that Telosa will strive to be the most open, fair, and inclusive city in the world. Imagine if you went into the desert where the property was worth nothing, or very little, and you created a foundation that owned the land, and people moved there, and tax monies developed infrastructure, and we constructed one of the greatest cities in the world, and the foundation's aim was to take the appreciation of the land and give it back to the citizens in the form of medical, education, cheap housing, and social services. The city is designed to be able to avoid infrastructure concerns and government rules that limit expansion in existing U.S. communities. According to the Telosa website, a clean slate provides the possibility to redesign a city with people's needs at the heart. We benefit from the knowledge, ingenuity, and competence gained since other cities in the United States were built. We can develop the most sustainable and resilient city that will serve as a model, while also assisting citizens in current communities. Entrepreneurs, mentors, educators, manufacturers, artists, students, telecommuters, and businesses would be welcome to settle in Telosa. The city is not meant to be a utopia, but it will seek to include sustainable methods of infrastructure, urban design, economic activity, and municipal services. Utopian projects seek to create a flawless, idealistic state. We do not. We are firmly founded in reality and what is attainable. Telosa, utopia or not, cannot be developed unless there is plenty of land accessible for construction. Texas, with roughly 172 million acres, could easily sustain a metropolis of about 200,000 acres. After all, the state is home to a number of enormous ranches, including the famous 825,000-acre King Ranch. The proposed city land ownership is based on Georgist ideals, which were promoted by political economist Henry George in his 1879 book, Progress and Poverty. Under the proposed laws, anybody would be licensed to construct, maintain, or sell a home, building, or other construction, and inhabitants would share land ownership through a community endowment. I don't have all the answers, but each day I'm learning, Lore said. All in all, Lore looks unfazed by the sheer amount of logistical processes and challenges required to bring Telosa from dream to reality. However, he is keeping his dream alive and hopes that one day Telosa could be the blueprint for sustainable cities of the future. So, what do you think? Will billionaire Marc Lore be able to achieve his dream city? Let us know your thoughts about Telosa in the comments down below. And if you want to see more mega-built videos, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Make sure to give us a like and we will see you in the next video.